From Fox 5 News, this is Good Day New York.
All right, it was a dramatic scene. Did you see this video? Two New York City firefighters severely burned while battling flames in Crown Heights, Brooklyn yesterday.
Well, now the Uniform Firefighters Association say that budget cuts may have contributed to their injuries. Listen to this.
The first engine company on the scene today previously had five. Today they had four. It took them an extra minute to a minute and a half to begin to get water on that fire.
All right, that's Uniform Firefighters Association President Steve Cassidy. He joins us right now. Welcome. First of all, how are the firefighters doing? Firefighter Weedman and Firefighter Gersbach. You visited them in the hospital?
I didn't get to see Firefighter Weedman. He's critically burned. They're expecting him to make a recovery. But he's burned severely over 40%, 45% of his body. It's a miracle he's alive. Firefighter Gersbach is doing okay. He's going to be okay.
You already came out and you talked about that possibly budget cuts were to blame for these firefighters getting injured. How do you know that so quickly?
Well, it's not budget cuts. It's staffing reduction as a result of budget cuts. And the reality is simply this. The New York City Fire Department was cut 10 times in the last 7 or 8 years. And I know that the Bloomberg administration has a responsibility to balance their budget. And all along, I was one of the people who accepted those cuts, except when they reduced staffing on engine companies. I said the results will be disastrous. And what happened yesterday is a result of that.
Why? What could have been different if there was another person there?
The fire department has their own studies. Five-man engines versus four. Engine 234, who put out that fire yesterday, was a five-man engine previously until the cuts. Now they're four. The fire department's own studies say that five versus four can be as much as twice as long to get water on the fire. What I said yesterday, conservatively, was one additional minute. It took them longer to get water on the fire because of the staffing cuts.
Now, I was a little surprised at the promptness of your response. I mean, the building is still smoking, and you're there saying that if Bloomberg hadn't cut our budget, perhaps these guys wouldn't have been burned. It's a dangerous job, and Kilduff, the chief here, said, look, operationally, we were there within 3 minutes. Water was flowing. That would not have made a difference. It was the speed. You know, you showed up. It's kind of like a political move. I see it all the time with politicians going, you know, the microphones are on. They make some sort of call before you necessarily know all the facts.
Greg, the reality is very simple. Five versus four isn't really five versus four. It's four versus three. And each engine company, one man is a chauffeur. He has nothing to do with stretching a line. So four versus three, you'd say, well, what's the difference? 25%. It's going to take 25% longer to get water on the fire.
They were there within 3 minutes on Prospect Place.
They were. They were there quickly. But so was Gersbach and so was Weedman. And they were already in the building. And the engine pulled up. And it took him an extra minute to get water on the fire. And those two guys are burned because of that. Nobody can say it's not true. The department's own studies say five versus four means a slower response in terms of getting water on the fire. Not me, them.
Yeah, but these things generally take some time to establish. You have to investigate. The building is still smoking, and you already know all the answers. You know exactly what happened. Nobody even knows how this fire started yet.
Greg, I didn't say anything about the fire. I didn't say anything about the building. What I said is the reality, simple facts. Five versus four means it's going to take longer if they're operating by themselves to get water on the fire. They were operating by themselves. It took them a minute longer to get water on the fire, and the results are catastrophic. Two firemen almost killed yesterday, one bailing out a window on fire.
Look at this video of the building on fire. Okay, we see the aftermath here. Right. But during the flames, tell us what you know about your men inside this building. What happened, and how did that one firefighter get in so much trouble up there?
15 seconds before Firefighter Weedman bailed out the windows. That room wasn't even on fire. The fire was in the back room of that building. I mean, if the fire department, if engine 234 had been there 30 seconds sooner, that wouldn't happen. If they were there a minute sooner, that fire never would have got out of the back room.
The chief of the fire department disagrees with you.
Well, that's his job.
His job is also to put out the fire,
no,
correct?
His job, he's appointed, by the way, and he's a very good guy, he's appointed by the mayor of the city of New York. His job is to defend their position. They made these.
Isn't that more the commissioner's job?
Well, you didn't see the commissioner, did you?
Right.
Did you see him make a statement yesterday?
This guy was more of an operational
person. So what are you saying, that the commissioner...
Well, the commissioner was responsible for allowing these cuts. You didn't see him on TV defending them yesterday, did you? I don't know why. He should have been there. Should have stood up and said to all the firemen across the city of New York, don't worry about it, it's not a problem, guys.
Overall, let's talk the history of the fire department and deaths of firefighters. Found some numbers. In the 1960s, 104 deaths. throughout the 1960s, 1970s, there were 68 deaths. And the number goes down. The 80s, 90s, and 2000s, excluding 9/11, it's about 20. How are we so far for the last decade?
Well, to be honest, things have gotten better. And the reason that both these
things have gotten better.
They have. The gear has gotten better.
The technology.
The gear. I mean, the gear that protects you. You know, listen, bunker gear allows firefighters to be in a burning building like that and survive. Of course, firefighter Gersbach and firefighter Weedman are critically burnt. Bunker gear also allows us to go deeper into burning buildings than we would have in the past. So we're able to save more lives, but we put ourselves in more jeopardy. And what happened yesterday, 5 seconds, you saw the water come out of the window from inside that building 5 seconds after he bailed out onto that ladder. 5 seconds sooner, it never would have happened. 30 seconds sooner, never would have happened. A minute sooner, that room would even be on fire.
We have to leave it there. Stephen Cassidy, president of the Uniform Firefighters Association, thank you.
Thank you.